are the children of yesterday's dream. We are the promise of the future we bring. Waving the banner of love to all, to every nation, the rich and the poor. We are a world of the restless and young, and we need a hand to guide us. Helping each other, build each other, as long as we're together, you and me. For together we stand, divided we fall. Together we climb to the top of the world. We can be what we want, for the world to see that we are the children of yesterday's dream. We have the yearning to do what is best, be someone special from all the rest. Nation and brothers in unity, building tomorrow for you and for me. We are a world of the restless and young, and we need a hand to guide us. Helping each other, build each other, as long as we're together, you and me. For together we stand, divided we fall. Together we climb to the top of the world. We can be what we want, for the world to see that we are the
Institute of Science and Technology,
College of Business Administration.
Pag-iwan lang po lang, one drop ako, wala na isa sa kanya. Thank you po.
Are you ready for the biggest event of the year? In two different locations. Two elegant speakers coming together. The next generation. Introducing our guest speakers is Rudy Maker Nahe, a supervising learning and development consultant at John Clements Consultant Incorporated. And Mr. Patrick Joseph Villora, a learning and development partner at Canva Philippines. Envision the future human resource, embracing the changes, shifting towards the new normal.
Thank you. Good morning, Philippines!
And hello, world! A warm greetings to everyone!
And to all aspiring HRs!
I am Armar Pinela.
And I am Floralyn Politas.
And we are your Masters of Ceremony.
Bago po natin umpisahan, meron lang po tayong mga munting paalala para po sa lahat ng mga viewers for today.
Ayun nga po, make sure na nasa tahimik tayong lugar with stable na internet connection para po marinig natin ng maayos ang kasabihin po ng o ipipresent ng ating mga guest speakers. And also po, huwag po natin kalimutang i-click sa comment section ang feedback form para po sa ating e-certificates.
And after a long time of waiting, we are finally here and I am so excited about this event. How about you, Armar? Are you excited?
Oo naman kasi diba, after a month of preparation ng mga hirap at marami pag-aaral, syempre, sobrang excited na, andito na tayo. Ito na yung time na hinihintay natin para sa ating webinar.
At dahil sa pinaka-aabangan na webinar na to, entitled
Envision the Future Human Resource Embracing Changes Towards New Normal. Diba? Parang walang COVID-19 sa atin.
Yes.
Mahalaga sa atin, matuto.
At hindi lang yan ang isa sa pinaka-aabangan natin. We have not just one, but two different speakers to share their knowledge today. So,
what are we waiting for, diba?
Yes.
Huwag na natin patagalin to. Let's do this.
To start this program is the prayer and be bowed by the Philippine National Anthem. Let us all bow our head and feel the presence of the Lord.
Let us put ourselves in the holy presence of our Lord. Our dearest Heavenly Father, thank you for making all things possible. We are grateful for all the blessings you are pouring upon each one of us, despite the challenges we are all currently facing. Thank you for blessing us today with the wonderful opportunity to meet virtually and learn together in the awesomely exciting webinar. May your blessings of wisdom and guidance be upon us, all through the sharing and impartation of knowledge and skills by our resource speakers, facilitators, and moderators. May all of us learn together, upgrade our competencies, and capacitate us to be the help in the development of our learners' lives and communities in the spirit of your love and generosity. May we now humbly commit every part of this webinar to you, as we all bring you the glory, honor, and praises for your kingdom and holy name's sake. All this we pray in the precious name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen.
Mga kababayan, ang pambansang awit ng Pilipinas.
Thank you.
Shout out sa lahat ng viewers natin
sa YouTube. Hello, thank you for being here today. And
from the start po, dapat hanggang sa matapos, nandiyan pa rin kayo. Tutok lang kayo kasi
marami tayong aabangan sa ating webinar for today.
Kasi nga, di ba? Hindi lang tayo isang speaker.
Yes.
Dalawa po speaker
marami
natin.
Marami tayong matututunan for today.
So, to officially start this program, may we call on Mr. Kimberly Christian Rueda, the overall committee chairman of HRDM 41, for the opening remarks.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. It is my great honor to welcome you on behalf of all of us Human Resource Development Management fourth year student to our webinar. First, I would like to thank our Honorable Dean, Dr. Willie Ogapasin, for giving us the opportunity to facilitate this kind of event. To our advisor, Professor Marivic Gimari, for the unyielding support to make this event possible for us. To my co-students, for their best effort for our webinar, and to our HRS family for promoting our event. We are truly grateful to all of you. It is your supports that enable us to put this event together. Professors, students, good morning. In these times, change is inevitable. For many, they call it setbacks, but for others, it's an opportunity for growth. I would say, let us not limit ourselves by what we currently know. Instead, let us all learn through these changes. Changes in terms of technological advancement, environmental changes, and modernization. Let us not be afraid of change. Rather, let this be our stepping stone to be the best version of ourselves. This is the very reason why we are conducting this event, to add knowledge about these changes and to be personally equipped with the right attitude to face future changes in our society. I won't be dragging this for too long. I hope everyone is excited to gain new set of knowledge that will forever be reminding us that change is not a setback. Rather, this is an opportunity for another growth. Thank you and mabuhay.
Thank you very much, Mr. Rueda, for that wonderful message. So, ano pang hinihintay natin?
Ayun na nga po, magsisimula na tayo. Pero bago po yan, syempre dapat sa lahat po ng ating viewers, pay attention po, take down notes, makinig ng mabuti. At during the presentation of our speaker, lahat po tayo makinig ng mabuti nang sa ganun po. Kung may mga gusto po tayong itanong, comment lang po natin sa ating comment box.
Okay po. At the end of this talk of our speaker, pipili po kami ng 3 questions para po to be answered by our guest speaker.
So ready na ba kayo, guys?
Are you ready, guys? And I am much ready. I am
ready
so excited about it. So, what are we waiting for? Mimi Colon?
Miss Jess Araneta to formally introduce our first guest speaker.
A pleasant morning to everyone. Our first guest speaker for today is currently the training manager at Ever Supermarket Manila. She earned her degree in Bachelor of Science in Business Administration, major in Human Resource Development Management, as cum laude in Far Eastern University, Manila. She is a recipient of various awards such as Academic Scholarship, Outstanding Senior Student of FEU, and Leadership Awardee of People Management Association of the Philippines. She is also the former National President of Junior People Management Association of the Philippines way back 2016. She also became part of John Clements Consultant Incorporated as Supervising Learning and Development Consultant. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Ms. Rudy Mae Garnacki.
Good morning, everyone. Okay. Let me just share my screen. All right. So good morning again, everyone. I hope you can hear me well and you can see my screen. So again, thank you very much for the invitation. I'm really thrilled to be spending this Saturday morning with you. And I know that the organizer put lots of effort to this. Actually, a while ago, while we're still... Hold on. All right. So... While the organizers are setting up, it made me, you know, reminisce the days 4 years ago that I'm also doing the same, organizing events, contacting speakers, and actually preparing for events like this. And so I want to take this opportunity first to congratulate all the organizers for putting lots of effort, and of course with their very supportive advisor moderator, Mrs. Mary Vic, that is really very hands-on to this event. So congratulations. I've been there before organizing events. I know the pressure and everything, and putting this together in a different mode, like in online module, it's really an accomplishment for the organization. So congratulations. Now, my responsibility is to give justice to the amount of effort that was put into this event. So the topic is Envision the Future Human Resource, Embracing the Changes, Shifting Towards the New Normal. So this is really an interesting topic, especially nowadays because of the pandemic and such, but I won't limit myself just focusing on the pandemic, but really on the whole human resource and the changes that affect the industry itself. So they want me to focus on changes, so I will just briefly go through with the things that is currently happening and really talk more about how it's really good, it's an opportunity and everything. So again, if you have questions, I think you can just comment below, and I hope you learned something new today. So let's start. So the future of human resource, we've been hearing this a lot for a couple of months or maybe years. But before that, I want to know, give me 2 minutes. All right. So okay, there you go. So if you can you please go to www.menti.com and use the code 8071295 and let me know, what are your thoughts when you hear the phrase, the future of human resource? What's the first thing or phrase that comes into your mind when you heard the future of human resource? Or what is it like that you visualize would be the future of human resource? Is it, you know, I don't know, robots or machines or those things? So I want you to go to this site and let me know, what are your thoughts? So ano yung mga kumbaga word associations, ano yung mga naiisip niyong words associated when it comes to the future of human resource? Sige nga, let's see. I will see if there's answers already. Okay, so these are real-time updates, that's why it keeps on shifting. Put this full screen. I think it's better. So okay, there are lots of words already. Just keep them coming. So the bigger the words or the phrases are, it means the more people actually answer that. So I think the top answers are robot, machine, AI, artificial intelligence, digital, some are responsible, technology, responsibility, transparent, leader, recruitment and selection, opportunity to navigate, handling people, great, good leader, payroll, workforce, paperless, human resources, multitasking, okay, robots, machine, successful, compassion online. So this is really great. I mean, this is like what we're foreseeing and what we're hoping the future of human resource will be. So thank you for everyone who actually answered. It's really hard to, you know, to nowadays to interact online, to get the response of people. So good thing there are these things that can do it for the meantime online. So let me just go back here. Okay, so those are your ideas of future of human resource, and it's really great. It's what we've been talking about for the past few years. But I want to tell you something. Those future of human resource that you mentioned earlier, it's no longer the future, because the future is now. It's currently happening. The robots, the artificial intelligence, this is really a big change in human resource in the industry that we're going to be part of for you after you graduate. So there are lots of advancements in human resource. I know some of you already heard or seen some videos and everything, but I wanted to show some as well. These are just short videos on what are the changes, the advancement in human resource in terms of different facets of HR. Earlier, there's a video presentation about what is human resource, and there are some of the facets like the recruitment and selection, training and development. I don't know if there's employee engagement, labor relations. Those, I think there's 8 facets of HR. So I won't discuss one by one, but I just pick some of the videos which are really interesting. So let me share with you some of those, and we'll discuss after. So here's the first video. I want you to watch this first. Just one example of the services that is now available in human resource. So is it nice that you have like an HR assistant on your phone, and they don't need to bother us as human resource about the policies, about the leave credits, and then you can also train them, ask for their feedback, how are they doing? So those things that really takes up a lot of time of HR practitioners are really put into this device, in this technology, which it's really convenient both for the employees and for the human resource. Because for employees, for example, at 11 p.m., you just decided to file a leave. Of course, it's not applicable right now because we cannot go anywhere. But during the when we're back to normal or to the this new normal, and traveling is now available, diba? If you can't sleep and then suddenly you wanted to travel somewhere else, but you don't know how many leave credits do I still have? So instead of bothering your HR or bothering us at 11 p.m. or, you know, midnight, you can have instant answer just using this technology. And I think this is really a great advancement in our industry. And there are a few more. So the next is in employee engagement. Before, the rewards and recognition is, you know, some are cash, but companies are really hesitant in giving cash kasi cash is so fluid that wala kayong sense of you cannot touch it in a way na, for example, if your price is or your rewards is like television, I don't know, refrigerator, washing machine, mga companies na may paganan oven or such. But also, we're not the same. We don't like the same things. For example, kung bibigyan ka, for example, ng TV, yet kakabili mo lang ng TV, and you cannot be choosy, of course, because this is rewards and recognition. The value of that, and for example, you really want to buy a washing machine on the same, let's just say, same amount, same price, but they give you TV, but it's the same amount with washing machine, but you need washing machine more. Let's just say that's the situation. But, di ba, you appreciate the TV, but parang mas kailangan ko talaga ng washing machine eh. So you end up, for example, selling the TV and buying for washing machine, right? So those things. But now, because of the technology, they have new platform wherein each individuals, each employees can choose their own rewards. So the HR cannot, ano na, don't need to have survey what are the prices that you want or ano pa bang mga kailangan ng tao just to make them more motivated or stay motivated with their job. Instead, they can let the people, their employees, choose. So here's also another interesting video that I wanted to show to you.
Research suggests rewards are a great motivator for employees, but the challenge is to reward employees with something that matches their expectation, something that brings a smile on their faces, while keeping back-end operations stress-free for department heads. Zozo de Plum seamlessly integrates with SAP SuccessFactors and makes the entire process, from rewards to redemption, hassle-free. Its end-to-end logistics and redemption support saves you from interacting with multiple vendors, cuts overheads, and offers better ROI on rewards program. Zozo de Plum offers a holistic catalog of over 21,000 rewards from over 17-plus different categories, like experiences, activities, gift cards, travel, hotels, entertainment, e-commerce, grocery, premium deals and discounts, lifestyle, health and wellness, and many more. Zozo de Plum allows you to redeem rewards in over 70 countries, and our dedicated catalog team can procure catalogs on demand, which means HR heads can sit back and relax without getting tangled in Excel sheets. Let's quickly see how it works. Log in to your SAP SuccessFactors. Under the Home tab, click on Compensation Module. You can...
Okay, I'll just pop it there. It's not a paid app, paid ad, by the way. So those are just a good examples of the different things that, you know, that we can do, right? That we can actually use when we're already in, you know, practicing HR. So it's really amazing that who would have thought that it's possible not to reward cash, but you can have the freedom to choose what the reward and recognition. The greatest value that the employee can get. So if you love traveling, so you can just book ticket using the points earned because of your rewards. If you're an excellent employee, so these are the things that really, wow, it's really amazing because the impact not just to the you know, the process of going to different vendors or having negotiation, it's really the impact on the employees that they will enjoy what the price that they really deserve. The next one is in learning and development, learning management system. So in my 4 years in working, I'm really focused on learning and development. So this is something that I really love. I mean, the advice on this is I really, really appreciate. So aside from like this, the webinar approach, there are also personalized training now being developed. Lots of companies here in the Philippines actually penetrating this market already. And it's really convenient both for the employees, the trainers, and the HR. So let's have a look.
Lisa manages a team and is proud of the people she's assembled to help her company grow. However, providing training and professional development opportunities can be a huge challenge. Some staff don't have time to complete long courses or onboard new employees, and others don't bother to read or watch the material she shares, leaving the company vulnerable to compliance risk. Hey, Lisa, why not check out GoOne, the online portal that makes training your employees and even your customers fast and easy? Using GoOne, companies of any size can get into the habit of providing bite-sized training on a regular basis. Businesses can also track their employees' progress and generate reports and certificates celebrating their accomplishments, which in turn creates a culture of positive professional development. Whether it's for volunteer training, employee upskilling, compliance, or delivering accredited courses, GoOne provides the perfect platform, enabling your training to occur at any time and anywhere. You get your own private portal where you can add personalized material that's specific to your business, as well as access to our growing marketplace of over 20,000 courses. So if your current training system consists of scattered documents, unorganized courses, and lost time, try GoOne.
Okay, so now, before the training, if it's done online or in a module, you will be receiving, you will be receiving lots of materials. But right now, because again of this technology that we currently have right now in the market, it's really for millennials and Gen Z, which is bite-sized information. You can just, you know, load it while you're stuck in traffic. You can just learn something. It's like 5 minutes read. So instead of, you know, Facebook, scrolling your feed, you're actually learning through this learning management system. And it's very personalized. So for example, you're interested in learning, let's say, leadership or specifically like how to handle team once you get promoted to a supervisors or manager. So you wanted to learn or just a refresher on what's the best way to lead your team. And because of this, you'll be suggested different topics, articles, videos, which are easy to digest. When I say easy to digest, it means it's really bite-sized information, straight to the point information that you really need. So, diba, it's not, because before, if you're studying, again, mag-aaral pa rin ako, it's really time-consuming and such. But because of this, it frees up your time. And also, as HR practitioners, you give support to the career growth and personal growth of your employees, which is really, really important. People managers that we are. And last, I think this is really the one that will interest you. I mean, there are lots of talks about robots and how it will change the workforce or the workplace. But right now, there are lots of robots already. There's Athena, I think Zeta. So those are the different names of the robots that are now present in the industry. So this will be, I think, the last video that I'll be showing, just for you to have like a background on, and meron ba talaga ganyan in the workforce, or is it just still like working paper and pen ongoing? But this is already the proof that this is already existing in the market. And actually, this one, I had the opportunity to try it. So,
hello, my name is Vera, and I'm a robot. And what's your name?
Hi, my name is Jason Bellini. This is Vera, a robot that does job interviews.
What are the three top important tips for a salesperson?
She's done 10,000 of them and counting.
Congratulations. We chose you as one of the best candidates for a sales representative.
What looks like the future is already a reality. Hiring is undergoing a revolution. Almost all Fortune 500 companies now use some form of automation.
She keeps winking at me and then rolling her eyes at me.
But many companies are also trying to look under the hood of job applicants and assess them in completely new ways.
You're quantifying human behavior, human expressions, human voices, turning that into data.
We're now using artificial intelligence to help companies find the very best talent.
And most likely you are being analyzed by an algorithm. How does that make you feel?
I feel like that would blindside me entirely.
Experts call the proliferation of artificial intelligence, machine learning, and data science tools the Wild West of hiring. Critics, and even some hiring managers themselves, say they're concerned about these tools' potential for bias. They raise issues like fairness, transparency, and accuracy.
So has the government taken a look at these algorithms to figure out whether they are within the law?
Not yet.
Thank you for an interesting dialogue. Have a nice day.
Thanks. You have a nice day too, wherever you are. Fingers crossed.
We begin our exploration.
Okay, so diba, it's really amazing that with the algorithms, they can actually compare your interview with other candidates as well as with the top performers in the organization to make sure that you're really fit for the job and the culture of the company. So this is really live. They are already here in the Philippines, actually. I was able to try this before. And it's quite strange because it's something new and you're not talking to a human being and you're very conscious that when your eyebrows or your nose or you tilt your head, there's all algorithms to it, like a lot of data points that they're trying to access. So it's really, really, it's amazing at the same time, quite scary. But again, this is the changes. This is the new things that is going to happen. And it's still improving. It's still on the works of improving. They say that it will limit the bias because there's no human, what do you call this? There's no human factor in it in the way that, for example, if you're in the same university, research says that you likely to tend to agree or hire people from the same background as you are. So there's no, with this technology, they are saying that they limit the biases, those kinds of biases, like how you look, how your preference, your gender identification, your religion. So those things are being limited. They claim that it's being limited. But again, of course, some are saying that, is it really accurate? Is it really match whatever it is? But currently, lots of big companies are really shifting to this because it's really easy. You can just put this in 100 interviewees and hire the best 2 or 3 in an instant. So that's really a great deal, right? Especially all of the videos that I shown you, it really makes life of us HR easier and for our employees' experience to improve. But the question here is, if these technologies can do our job, is HR already extinct? So that's the question here. If the robots can do the interview, if artificial intelligence, machine learning can do the, even the employee engagement, even the training. So are we extinct? I mean, sorry for the graphics. I really love this scene from the movie and I really love it. So I tried to just put it there. So anyway, so what do you think after you graduate? I mean, some of you will be graduating next year, some of you 2 or 3 years from now. So do I still have a job after 4 years of studying in the university, in the college? And then I will be replaced by this technology, this robot. So yeah, so the question is HR extinct? May trabaho pa ba tayo in the near future? So the answer is yes, definitely. So there's a big shift. I think that's the best term that I can think of. There's a big shift. So there are changes in the industry, there are changes in human resource, and also there's a change in our job. So the big shift. So all of the materials that I've been sharing with you are based on, some of them are based on my research, some are based just online and look at it, and it's those things that are repetitive in different credited sources. I just put them together and also with based on my experience. So the big shift. So from being doing the clerical works, doing the paperwork, now we can focus more on people, which is they're saying that human resources are people managers. And I really agree to this. We are really, our priority should always be our people. But again, we cannot blame the HR people for doing lots of things because it's operations and it will have, a stoppage of work if they don't focus on these things. Like, for example, how will you focus on people if the compensation, if the salary, ano na, kinsenas na, and you need to make sure that people will have their salaries. Of course, your priority is their salaries because these are operations. They are expecting it and people needs, of course, money on time. So, of course, that's your priority. But because of the advancement that we've been talking about earlier, the shift, the freeing of lots of time, the effort, and you have more time to really focus on people. Next is continuously evolving. This is the things, the videos that I showed to you right earlier are already happening, but it doesn't stop there. There's still continuously evolving, and who knows, 5 years from now, there are still another big shift that will be going to penetrate in the HR industry. So it's continuously evolving, and so we should as well. Next, workforce advisor and coaches. As what I've mentioned earlier, before, we're really focused on getting the job done. But right now, because of this technology, if we apply them the right way, we can have more time to actually communicate with our employees, ask for feedback, how we can improve our services, and also not just to our employees, but also to the top management. We value our opinions and etc. Next is strategic partner. And along this presentation, you will be seeing lots of strategy because I think this is the best association in HR, being a strategic partner. We'll be able to help the company shift the direction, improvement. And I think this is because we really see the big picture here. And the people is always the fuel in an organization. And we're priority is our people. So this is really, I think strategic partner is the best term if we can associate it with the HR people. And lastly, joining top management. Before, there are really few HR practitioners who are in the top management. It's not because we are less capable or, but it's really the finance people, the marketing people, which is, they are really great, by the way. But right now, we are given the opportunity to actually step up. There are lots of senior vice presidents who are now, who are HR. There are few president in the company were actually graduated from HR. And before, it's not normal that HR will be leading the entire organization because their focus really is the people, the policy creation, the day-to-day basis, the recruitment, regular recruitment, the salary every twice a month. So now, because you're freeing up lots of efforts to do those things, they can, you know, learn, we can learn and actually be part of the top management. Because before, we're just facilitating the discussion of the top management. Okay, we'll do this, we'll do that. You jot down notes and you implement it. But right now, we have the voice, we have the power to actually voice out what we think is beneficial for our company. Now, breakthrough approaches in HR. Let's make it work. So these are the things that we need to actually embrace because this is how we're going to be stay track on the game. So these are the breakthrough approaches in HR. First, we need the acceptance of technology. I think this is easier for you because you're millennial and Gen Z. So you are really the mobile generation. You were raised up na katabi nyo our cell phones, tablets, and such. So I think this is easier for you because Gen X, wala pang technology on their younger days. And they really need to adapt. For us, I'm part of Gen Y or millennials. We're on the middle. We're used to the traditional. And during our, you know, young or siguro mga grade school, technology was introduced to us. So we're in the middle. So we kind of accept both of, you know, both the spectrum. But you guys, you're the mobile generation. I think it's easier for you to actually accept the technology now open in the market. So as we've mentioned previously, the rise of chatbots, digitalization, machine learning, and artificial intelligence, and it will still continue to evolve. It will still continue to rise in terms of number, in terms of capabilities. So instead of us doing the, you know, man work, the technology can do it for our benefit and focus on strategic decision making, being strategic partners and whatnot. Automate then reskill. This is really important. Some people doesn't accept technology because they think they fear that they will lose their job or they won't be relevant anymore in the company. So they try to, diba, negative yung approach immediately. But the thing here is automate then reskill. If those, you know, things you can do it digital and then upload it online, for example, the policies or the let's say company handbook, and then people can just, if they have questions about, for example, the attire or the policy on plates and such, instead of going to you, they can just log in and then search for it in online hand, and that's it. So it's actually automation because you're making your life easier. But some things that because of those things, it may lead for them to be unemployed. So the trick here is automate, then don't forget to reskill. So if you're going digital, if you're doing lots of investment in this technology, you also need to reskill the employees for them to be able to stay tuned with what's going on in the environment. So for example, in recruitment, let's say you're sourcing, your task or your job is really focused on sourcing. Sourcing means you're gathering the resume, those who are passively looking for a job, you're tapping them and try to fit them into the current job openings and such. So if we can already automate it, if the system, and these are also present in the market, if the system can already give you, let's say, let's search learning and development, and then supervisory level, and then what else? Specific criteria like working in Makati. Let's just say those criteria. And if you search it in the software, and it will appear na already those CVs that are qualified for the criteria that you mentioned. So you don't need necessarily sourcing people for that. So you automate it, free up their time, and then make them more useful. Like for example, you can ask them to do the final interview, or they can do the job offer. So it's really automate then reskill. It should go both hand in hand. Next is improve employee experience. We've been mentioning this earlier. Improving employee experience, not just your employees, but our employee experience as HR managers. We don't need to be bothered by the same questions every cut off, tatanungin how much is the SSS contribution or how to loan for whatever. So those things, it will really improve our employees because anytime it's available, and our time as well. We don't need to answer them repetitively. It's already there. And again, I've mentioned that you'll be hearing a lot of strategic from me this morning. So more time for strategic planning. So more impact in the organization, being proactive rather than reactive. The next is corporate planning. This is the next approach that we need to actually embrace. So first is revisit and realign the vision, mission, and core values. So because the technology is there, take a look if this is still applicable to your vision, mission, and core values is still applicable to what the company is currently doing. If not, you need to, of course, change it. Of course, with the approval of the top management. Hindi ka naman pwede mag-change basta-basta because this defines your company. So you need to propose and actually recommend, because we're on the era of digitalization, what can we inject from our vision, mission, and core values that actually transpire that technology-driven company. Next is, again, strategic direction, both economic and social. People or companies nowadays are really big in CSR, corporate social responsibility. So there are lots of talks about sustainability, and organizations or companies are really investing on these practices. And this is, I think, really good because we're becoming more responsible citizens in our community. And lastly, solutions provide their critical thinker and being proactive, which we mentioned earlier. So ask yourself, what are the problems of a CEO? And try to come up with recommendations to that. Because as HR, as mentioned earlier, we are now the workforce advisors. So just politely give your recommendations. And because we're now being proactive, now foresee na natin what could go wrong in the future, and we can actually derive some solutions before it actually happens. Next is the focus is on people. Again, we are people managers, so this is, I think, the most important among this. I will be mentioning four approaches, and I think this is really the most important approach. Focus is on people. So let's create an environment where people enjoy working and can't imagine being anywhere else. So this is really, I think this is really the main priority of HR people. They keep on saying that HR people are part of management, which is, of course, true. But also, we are the voice of the people in the top management. So I think make sure that link, that being middle between the people and the top management, you can do lots of things because your heart is on the right place, diba? So make most out of it. Now you go with the policies that really is benefiting your people. Again, people are the reason why your company is succeeding. Without your people, diba, wala. I mean, sales revenues are really important because that's why we're putting up business. That's why where we get our resources. But again, the people are the one who parang gas, who is really pushing forward to the success of the company. And also, mind you, that if your company has a high turnover rate, which means lots of people are leaving, that's really accumulating costs, because the costs in recruitment, the cost of training people, and then they will leave for a certain period of time, for a year or less than a year. It's really a cost because you need to retrain people, and there's this learning curve. So So hindi naman yan in the first 2 months you expect your people to produce immediately. Of course, there's a learning curve. They will still learn the ropes in the business, especially for you guys since you'll be fresh graduates. So it might be too overwhelming. You'll be learning a lot. So just make most out of it. And as HR people, let's make sure that our people are happy and they don't want to leave the organization. And lastly, continuous learning. This is really my favorite, I don't know, quote, or maybe this is my motto, life mantra. Live as if you were to die tomorrow. Learn as if you were to live forever. I think this is really, really important. This is from Mahatma Gandhi, by the way. Continuous learning is really important, especially to us, because, again, our industry is evolving. The world is actually evolving. So we need to cope up. But how? Continuous learning. And I think every one of you is on the right track because you're attending this webinar on a Saturday morning, joining us. And I think you already have that passion to learn. And it's still continuous. Even if you're 40s or 50s, you need to learn, still continuously learning, because, you know, there are lots of, it never ends. Knowledge never ends. So just learn and apply it. Hindi naman learn lang and then you're not applying it to your respective companies in the future. You also need to actually share your learnings to other people. So again, these are the 4 breakthrough approaches. There are still lots. I think you can just go online and you will see lots of breakthrough approaches, but I really wanted to focus on these 4. Okay, now the new normal. So I will just pass through this topic about the new normal, because this is really a time of uncertainty. We don't know if, and of course, we're hoping that by the time next year, balik na ulit talaga sa normal. But of course, we don't know again. So maybe when you graduate, it's still like this, wearing face mask in the company. So I'll just run through with you so that you will not be shocked naman or surprised on ano ba yung pinasok nyo in the organization if this pandemic still goes on. But again, let's hope we flatten the curve and help each other to flatten the curve. So I just will briefly run through this. So the new normal in the organization, as you can see in this picture, of course, the QR code, it's also working in other establishments, restaurants, and such. So this is important for contact tracing so that if there's an incident of, you know, reported positive and you're with the same person at the same time in a specific establishment, you can have self-quarantine and protect yourself and your family from, you know, from that, from spreading the virus. So this is actually important. People are, I know it's really hassle when you're entering different establishments and then you need different QR code, but this is really, really important for contact tracing. So let's do it. Don't skip contact tracing. So yeah. Then next is safe distancing, and we're practicing this also in outside, even if not just in the workforce, so that even if if you're positive, but for example, I don't know asymptomatic, I don't know that I actually have COVID, and then for example my workmate has weaker immune system, so that, you know, hindi ko siya makahawaan or anything. So again, wearing face mask, safe distancing, and you can see, of course, alcohol, and then this team A, team B. So most companies do this shifting so that if it will just contain few people lang yung nakakapag-interact with each other, and also wag naman sana, but if there's a positive incident of positive for team A, so buong team A, they can quarantine and there's continuity of work because team B will still be managed to do the job. So those are the things that the current practices in the organizations right now. Again, I don't want to discuss this because I'm really, really hopeful that this will end by the time you guys graduated next year. So I really hope, but these are the things that we practice. And again, let's help in studying the crew. So again, these are the things that ano yung iiwan sa atin because of this pandemic. Even before pandemic, washing hands, putting alcohol and things like that. These are really important, but not common. So there are really few people na after mag-restroom, they just, you know, go out without washing their hands. But because of this pandemic, diba, it's now parang routine na after you touch anything outside or after you go to their bathroom, you wash your hands. And this is really important, even without the pandemic. Next, who would have thought that we can do online meetings like this? I mean, before, if you have meetings, for example, your work, your office is in the north, and you have meeting on the south, like 4 hours traffic, let's say three, four hours traffic, you're stuck on traffic just to be in a meeting. Where in fact, we can actually do this online. And I hope that companies will continue to practice this. I know it's really important, the personal, you know, the face-to-face, because if for, especially for salespeople, to make them feel na yung client nila is important. But again, 4 hours, imagine in 4 hours, you could have finished lots of job, but instead, you are stuck in the traffic. So, who would have thought that this is really possible, diba? The online online meetings, online learning, so make most out of it. So, these are the changes or what do you call the realizations because of this pandemic. Pwede naman pala na we can meet halfway using in the comforts of our office or of our home and do the important meetings. Next is online e-commerce. Like a lot of, even before pandemic, there are online stores already. But because of this pandemic, there's really a shift in the buying power, buying pattern of the people. So before, you need to shop physically, and syempre, if you will going to shop or buy in a restaurant or whatsoever, you will commute or you will drive your car and it will cause traffic. But now, it's really hassle-free. Just order online. Almost everything is now online. And it's really amazing, diba? It's very convenient and you can just stop and then pay and then it will be delivered to you. Next, this is important because before, it's really a practice that when you meet new people, you will shake their hands. But right now, they say that this is the new normal, the elbow pump. So that, diba, walang physical, walang contact because we use our hands frequently. Our elbows, parang sabi nila, less virus and such. So, mamaya, when you're new in the company and you want to shake hands, of everyone kasi yun yung nakasanayan nyo before this, you know, this lockdown. So this is the new normal. So instead of shaking hands, it's elbow bump. And lastly, it's putting an emphasis on mental health. So self-care isn't selfish. So I know there's lots of struggles because of this pandemic. And we have, all of us have our own issues right now that we're trying to work on. But not all of us has the same ability or capability to be able to, you know, to drive those emotions, overwhelming thoughts and such. So let's be extra kind to everyone. And this is really, really important. And I'm really happy because people nowadays are really open to this. Now we are more sensitive on the emotions of other people. And I think because of this pandemic, mas na strengthen yung respect natin for people's emotional stability. Because maybe you're physically well, but you're not mentally or emotionally well. So let's not forget to check also ourselves as much as we check other people, our family, our loved ones. So this is also a big shift. If you will imagine, before no one really cares or very few people really cares about this. But right now, there are lots of support system, and as HR, if you're in the company, you should also make an initiative to make this somewhere in place in the company. So, just few points about the HR's response to COVID. So, for employees, ano to eh, because in our case, in the organization, like there, it's quite sudden in less than, I think, 2 days to announce the lockdown. So this is really, really important part of HR is really, really important in the implementation or the response to COVID. So it was HR's job to make sure that remote working is possible provide assistance with adjusting from work from home lives, because everyone is at home. If you're, I don't know if you have kids, or if you in your case, your parents are also working and you're there doing your online class, the bandwidth in the internet, the technology, because not everyone has laptops naman, but how are we going to shift those things? So those things are the things that HR did during this this ECQ or GCQ. GCQ muna yung nauna. ECQ. And then consider employees' health and well-being. Again, there are lots of online training regarding the health and well-being, daily check-ins, how are you, how is your family, how are you coping up? Because this is really a difficult time. It's really, really difficult time. So we need to give extra effort to make sure that our employees or we are all well. Next, efforts were made to make employees productive, motivated, engaged, and connected. So we have, you know, check-ins, meetings, online meetings, virtual meetings. We still need to continue different employee engagement, movie nights, karaoke nights, inuman sessions with the company. So those things, we need to still be connected with our office mates, colleagues, kasi it's really difficult to work alone. And if you're swamped up, you cannot talk to anyone, because the usual thing here is if you're done with your task, you'll stand, you have a quick conversation with your friends in the company, so that to make you focused again. But right now, it's really difficult. So make an effort to make those things available. Like, there are lots of online platforms for messaging and things like that. Next, build strong relationship with trust as the foundation. Of course, we don't know if our employees are really working, but we need to empower them to make that decisions for them and to trust them that even though with less or no supervision at all, they are able to do their job well or to complete their job. For the company naman, roll out new policies for remote working. Of course, all companies has to draft something for the remote working arrangement of their employees. Reshape the workplace by introducing companies' work from home culture. So this is different, because we're now working online. We practice different things compared to the office setup. So what will be the culture now in the organization? And then forward-thinking mindset, again, being proactive, provide recommendations. And again, they are saying that this pandemic is the HR's leadership moment. This HR is really the driver for this. And again, CEO's advisor. Again, dealing with changes, there are lots of changes happening right now in your life. There are plot twists nowadays in different facets of our life. So for you, once you graduated, and you'll graduate, hopefully not, but if you graduate during this, you know, still ongoing pandemic, so it's a big life change. It's a transition. So there are lots of things, kasi you're shifting from school to offices, shifting from your friends to new work colleagues. So it's a lot to process. Next is changes in technology. We've mentioned this before. Change in the workforce in terms of, yeah, before it's Gen X and millennials, and it's really a hard time. There are lots of initiatives just to make those two generations work. But right now, you guys, the Gen Z, you'll be the one to enter the market, and there will be very, very diverse in terms of workforce. So it's really a lot to process, lots of changes. How are we going to accommodate three different unique or generations? And of course, change in the workplace because of this pandemic. So there are lots of uncertainties in all these facets, and maybe more with your relationships with people, with your friends, with your family. So this is really a time of uncertainty. We don't know if by the time you graduate, by the time next year, 2021, it's all over. Of course, we're hopeful, but we don't know it. It's really uncertain. Magi-invest ba ako sa magandang work from home setup? Will it be sustainable? Will it be something na will make add value to my job? We don't know, because this is really lots of questions, uncertainties that no one knows actually the answer. So it's really difficult to navigate to this. But because of this change, let's talk about change. So big word, big letters, change is a big word. So let's talk about change. And I will, this is just the, I think the ending, I'm almost done. So change, it's an opportunity not to waste. I mean, there are lots of personal barriers in change, because if you change something, you're not comfortable to do it. If you're, for example, you're now changing your friends, not really changing, but you have new friends and there's a change on your in your barkada. Before, in your college barkada, you are already familiarized with them, how to communicate with them, how to deal with them. And now you're going to the office, more professional. How are you going to balance that professional and friendly relationship with your colleagues? So it's not comfortable to change. And there are lots of personal barriers. I used to this, I'm successful doing certain way, why do I need to change? For example, I'm good at recruitment, so why I need to change? I'm good at training people, doing lectures, hands-on demo and such. Why do I need to adapt to these changes and work with technology if I can do it on my own? But again, this is an opportunity for you. This is an opportunity for everyone to improve ourselves. Let's say if you're freeing up lots of those tasks and actually focusing on different things at the same time, diba? It's really, really for your personal and professional growth. Say, these changes really brings out probably the best and the worst for you, and it's up to you to decide which one are you in those two compelling ideas. Next is develop positive outlook. Again, it's all in the mind. It's how you embrace these changes. And I think this is really something that differentiate us from other people. Let's say, for example, because of this pandemic, you're doing online classes or whatnot. But some, and you don't need to travel for, I don't know, 1 hour, 2 hours, because your school is in Manila, so quite traffic, right? So you're freeing up your 2 hours commute going to and from your school. So if you have this positive outlook, you will make that an opportunity to, I don't know, to learn something new, maybe enroll to online. There are lots of free online classes on the internet, Harvard, Wharton. There are really different organizations and universities that are opening up. So if you have positive outlook, instead of being unproductive, doing Facebook or Netflix, of course, we need those things, but also manage your time well and being able to make it on your advantage. Instead na maging distraction siya, be it, make it as your advantage. Instead of being unproductive, do something productive. Maybe learn a new skill, being, you know, plantito, plantita, or cooking, and you will be surprised, because a lot of people nowadays, they discovered their passion, their hobbies, because of this pandemic. So they did not waste the opportunity, and they have this positive outlook. How will I make most of the time that I have right now since I'm at home? So those things. Next, it comes with innovation. And innovation is really important, being able to provide advancement, improvement. Because if there's no innovation, you will be stagnant. Yung nandiyan ka na lang for the rest of your life. And of course, as people managers or people person, diba, we always strive to improve ourselves. Kasi boring naman if we stop on the same job for the rest of our lives, for the 30, 40 years in our lives, diba, you won't appreciate the value of what you're doing, kasi yun na lang. But if there's an innovation and you have positive outlook again, and you don't waste the opportunity to actually change, you continuously improve for your own benefit, and your skills are widening up and makes you more irreplaceable in the company, and make you more confident about yourself, which makes you more more useful. And mas meron kang, the most important thing there is yung self-actualization mo, di ba? Maslow's hierarchy of needs, yung self-actualization mo, that I've done this, I've been able to innovate, I've been able to change from the, you know, from the college me to this new me, corporate me. So it's really great. And lastly, change, it's either you accept it or regret it. Again, change is the only thing that is constant. And this is something that we really, really need to be able to accept, or rather, we will fail and regret it. Even if you don't change, the people around us, the systems, the things around us will eventually change. So we really need to make sure that we are also changing and evolving, or else we'll be left behind. So those are the things. And now, this is my last slide. This is just key takeaways. I'm almost out of time, or I'm already out of time. So these are the key takeaways. First, change is constant. Be creative. As I've mentioned, we talked about the future of HR, and the future is now. It's currently happening. There's already changes in the company. There's a change in the lifestyle. There's a change in the world because of this pandemic. And there will always be changes along the way. So be creative about it. Again, make it useful to your advantage rather than make it as your disadvantage. Next is how you react. Again, it's all in the mindset. If you have this positive, clear mindset, you'll be able to do it. I think this is really, really, really important. How you embrace change, how you are open to it. It's not comfortable at first, but the thrill on changing, it's something that you need to experience and actually enjoy at the same time. Next, act like an executive. So I'm not saying na bigla ka na lang, you're a fresh grad and then you're gonna act like you're already the boss. Of course, what I mean about acting like an executive is, think about if you're the president of the company, what are the things that you should be doing right now? Or what are the things that I can recommend so that it will make the workplace more efficient, effective? So even if you're a fresh grad, start acting like an executive. So if you're doing something, ask yourself, is this something that will make me an executive, or is this something that an executive will do? For example, if you're torn, if it's the right thing or not, just ask yourself about it, and maybe, hopefully, you'll find the right answer with it. Next, this is the new reality. We cannot control it. We just need to accept it and be able to change for it. And I think we acceptance really is the key here. This is the new reality. No one has the ability to stop this from coming or anything else to avoid. So this is it. This is the new reality. So we really just need to adapt to it. Go for the goal. Whatever the changes in your career, in your life, if you have set goals, and I think this is really a good activity. If ngayon pa lang, of course you won't do it, but just, you know, try to set your goals. In 5 years from now, I'll be this, I'll be that, I'll be accomplishing this, I already have my own this, and then actually I have this and I put it in my wallet, just a reminder of the things that I wanted to do in life. And every day I open it up and think if I'm close to my goal, or what are the things that I need to change for me to be able to reach that goal. So it's kind of helpful. If one day you're bored of the toxic in social media, you don't want to do Netflix, and you're too lazy to do chores or whatsoever, just, you know, a quick, just like three things, the goals that you want to achieve in the next 5 years, and put it somewhere na hindi mo laging nakikita, and then you'll be just surprised, and pag nakita mo siya, and you'll read it, and wow, I've come this far from this to this. So again, go for the goal. Whatever it happens, as long as your eyes is on the prize, you can make it. Lastly, embrace it. Embrace all the changes, appreciate it, and have the right attitude and the right mindset. again, I mentioned to you earlier that they want me to focus to change, and this is how I want to close. I'm sorry, I think I overtime na, so I'm really sorry for that. But I really hope that you've learned something this morning, and let's connect. If you have anything else that you want me to help you with, I'm really open to it, because you know it's really important to have someone you can talk to, especially nowadays. So I've done this, you know, before when I was like you, student. As a student, I really communicate with the resource speakers that I've been interacting with, and really I really learned a lot from them. And now it's my time to pay it forward and actually do the same thing to you guys. So I think that's it. I hope you are all well and safe, and I hope we can do this and meet you in person very soon. And that's it. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, Miss Rudy May Carnaje.
Thank you so much po. That was such a remarkable presentation of yours po.
And I am sure that our audience now has a lot of questions, and they have full of knowledge they get from your talk, Miss Carnaje. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, Miss Carnaje. Meron po tayong dalawang question. So, the first question po para sa inyo ay galing kay Miss Brenda Llanera. The question is, what do you think will be the effect of the new normal practices with regards to the productivity of the employees?
Sorry, can you repeat that?
What do you think will be the effect of the new normal practices with regards to the productivity of the employees?
Okay, so hold on. Okay, can you hear me now? Is it clear?
Yes,
ma'am. Okay, sorry. So how is it affecting the new normal? So I already mentioned this before, and there are lots of things that is going on right now, and lots of intervention from HR. So how are we, the question is, I'm distracted with my computer. Can you repeat that?
Okay, okay, ma'am. Ito po. What do you think will be the effect of the new normal practices with regards to the productivity of the employees?
Okay, so I really think this is an opportunity for HR to step up with their current work from home policies. And some companies are still 100% online working, and some have this shifting in the office. So the productivity is really it really depends on how the company is adapting to it. First, some companies are doing regular check-ins, so to make sure that what are your agenda for today, what are your deliverables for today, do you need any help, because now it's really hard for the employees to actually approach the management or their managers, because it's all online. So have that culture of open communication is really, really important. Be connected now more than ever, because we really need that, especially if we're not seeing each other physically. So make most out of it using the social media, using the different platforms that are now available. So I think if I have one thing that I want to emphasize on, is communication. It's really, really important.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you so much, po.
Here's the last question, ma'am, from Jafet Lapidario. If the robots will do the job interviews in the future, what would be the essence of human? Also, would it have the same care of compassion that humans have to applicants?
Actually, there's a big talk about that. Robots are really great in terms of the technical, but how about the emotional side? But there's this robot, I think the name is Sophia, if you can try to Google it or search for it. And I think they claim that they have this emotional attachment to it. So the Sophia knows if the person she's talking to is mad or upset, and she can try to lighten up the mood. They claim it, but it's still a work in progress. But the first question is what are we going to do? I think I already answered that in the presentation, that we need to reskill, we need to improve and focus more of the strategic side of the company. And also it's still a work in progress, and I think we're really close to having those robots have emotions as well. Of course, it will never be the same in human being, but they also claim that emotions are the primary reason wherein the interviews are biased. So that's why they say that it's better to have the robot interview, to say you don't have that emotional attachment, meaning you don't have biases. If, for example, it's really focused on the job itself, not on your background, on your your family, your history, and such. So they say that it's really nice that those things doesn't really have that compassion level. Para talaga fit for the job. There's no politics into it. Walang familiarity complex. So I think that's how we go about those. How I will answer that question.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you so much, ma'am.
Now we may proceed to the handling of certificate.
Yes. Well, to read the plaque of appreciation for you, Ms. Carnahe, may we call on Sheena Mercado to read the plaque of appreciation.
Eulogio Amang Rodriguez Institute of Science and Technology, College of Business Administration, Human Resource Development Management. Certificate of Appreciation is presented to Rudy May Carnahe in grateful recognition for sharing her expertise and professional competence as webinar speaker on the topic Envision the Future Human Resource, Embracing the Changes, Shifting Towards New Normal, given this 12th of December 2020, Iris Manila. Signed, Kimberly Christian Q. Rueda, President, HRDM 41, Professor Maribic S. Guimari, Advisor, HRDM 41, Dr. Charlene U. Escario, Area Chairperson, HRDM, and Dr. Willie O. Gapasin, Dean, College of Business Administration.
Yay! Thank you so much, Sheena. Ms. Carnahe, the certificate po will deliver to you personally by Ms. Handayan and Ms. Malyari po, together with the token of appreciation. Maraming salamat
Thank
po muli po.
Thank you so much,
po.
Ma'am. And we hope to see you again, ma'am. Thank you.
Yes,
Thank
po. You. Salamat, ma'am.
Thank you.
Okay. And before we proceed to the next part of our program,
Do you want some icebreaker dyan,
yes,
guys?
Alam ko na medyo gusto nyo na ng pampainit ngayon.
So ano pang hinihintay natin? Let's give it up for Miss Angel Rises.
Flipped on the beat.
Ako'y lasing na kanina pa. Kala mo ba di ko napapansin na nakatitig ka sa aking mata? Ba't kung makatingin ka sa akin parang may balak ka? Gusto mo bang tanungin? Alukin ako ng alak pa. The way you look into my eyes, I know you want it. Huwag mo kong subukan, dare me, I will take you home, yeah. Bago pa maubusan ang tao, uminom na tayo. Huwag ka nang magpapipot, sayawan mo na ako. Kaya mo yun, huwag kang matakot. Pangakong di ka mapapagod. So, baby, can I dance with you tonight? Dance, dance with you tonight. Dance, dance with you tonight. Dance with you tonight. ka, ubod ng kulit. Hatakin ka, basta may sayo ka ulit. Papayag ka ba na sumama sa'kin pa uwi? Mamaya na huwag kang magmadali, yeah, yeah. The way you look into my eyes, I know you want it. Huwag mo kong subukan, dare me, I will take you home, yeah. Bago pa maubusan ang tao, uminom na tayo. Huwag ka nang magpakipot, sayawan mo na ako. Pareha, kaliwa ang paa, pilit ka karera para makasayaw ka at makapareha. Patay man ang ilaw o liwanag man natin tila gasera.
Yes, what an amazing performance, Miss Rises.
Sana all, magaling sumaya.
Yes, ang galing. So, before we proceed, we would like to remind all of you guys that
the feedback form po, this will automatically open after this webinar.
So stay tuned para po tayo makapag-register after this webinar. Okay, so yes. Are you ready, guys, to meet our second speaker?
Yes.
So what are we waiting for?
Ito na nga po, to formally introduce our second guest speaker, may we call on Ms. Cheryl Barcelona?
It is my great pleasure to present to you our second speaker this morning. He is a learning and development professional with experience spanning over 15 years. He has worked with diverse companies, a BPO, a multinational bank, and a technology startup. All instrumental in shaping his love for learning. He has taken on several L&D roles during his stints with these companies, a facilitator, an instructional designer, a learning consultant, a business partner, operations lead, data analyst, and vendor manager, among others. An introvert by nature, 99% according to his MBTI results. He likes to spend his downtimes geeking out on anything he fancies that day, from grunge music, Pinoy flip top, classical ballet, religious documentaries, conspiracy theories, basically anything. He also loves driving around, literally. He would sometimes hop in his car and drive aimlessly without any destination in mind. He can spend an entire afternoon just people watching, observing all their quirks and eccentricities. He loves watching documentaries more than reading books, but that does not mean he doesn't want reading the latest Crichton, Grisham, or Sheldon he can put his hands on. Ladies and gentlemen, let's give him a round of applause, Mr. Patrick Joseph Villora.
Guys, hear me okay? So thank you for the introduction. I am Patrick Villora. I am a learning partner, which I'll be spending a bit of time what a learning partner is. But for today, indulge me with your a bit of time as I share with you some of the things that I actually love. And it's a topic that I've talked about with friends, with family, and definitely my colleagues. And these are, you know, the shifting realities in our workplace as a result of the pandemic shifting towards the new normal. So once again, I am Patrick Villora. I am a learning partner. Well, technically, I am a learning consultant with Canva Philippines, but I'm not here representing Canva. If you're not familiar, Canva is an application tool. I don't know if some of you are using Canva already, but it's a technology company. It's a design app. We are an Australian startup, and we have operations here in the Philippines. But prior to that, I started my corporate life as an agent in the BPO industry, where I spent my first 8.5 years of my professional career rising from the ranks of an agent until I became a senior training professional. Then I moved to a multinational bank, and that's really where I guess my perspective and experience, not just in L&D, learning and development, but really in HR was honed, primarily because it was in this job where I had experience the entire HR realm. But on top of that, I really am passionate when it comes to learning. I am passionate about anything that I can geek out on. And kung naririnig ninyo, I actually have dogs with me. And if you're interested to know, I have 17 dogs with me. And some of them were rescues from friends. So wala pa namang lumalapit sa bahay na nagsasabing ninakaw namin yung aso. So I think it's safe to say that I did rescue them. But the pandemic that has happened really shifted a lot of things. In the education space, for example, the reason why we are doing this is a result of that. The reason why we go out with masks on and it's if it's pretty normal is another impact of the pandemic. So siguro hindi nyo pag-aano natatandaan, but hindi siya a few years ago, but in around 2001, 2002, when there was an outbreak of anthrax, there were some people that were wearing masks. However, it wasn't a fad. Even when SARS came out, which is actually still part of, or is still a coronavirus-driven disease, ang SARS po at ang COVID ay magkapamilya. Still, masks wasn't in. Now, as I know, what I really thinking about is, you know, the pandemic really is something unique because it has shifted a lot. Okay. Now, on March 16th of this year, we were all placed under the enhanced community quarantine. But if you take a look at a few days before that, March 15, nag-GCQ tayo. That was a one-day shift, ladies and gentlemen, sa araw lang. And businesses were not ready. And as a result, what actually happened was non-essential travels were restricted almost immediately. Nag-close po lahat ng airports, lahat ng ports, even land transportation came to a full stop. Even those that had private cars were not allowed to move. Many businesses ceased operations. We thought it was just for a few weeks because in the initial announcement, it was up until April 14th only. And movement of people were limited and restricted. All of a sudden, the world as we know it stopped, and in the months that followed, it has changed the landscape. Hindi lang po sa business, but you know, everything that we are doing. All of a sudden, magkakasama tayo sa bahay kumakain. All of a sudden, you see your siblings, if you have one, you see your parents almost 24/7. Things that we were not doing in the past, we get to do together now. I remember some people were saying they discovered new things about their siblings, their partners, that they have not known for a very long time. Ako naman, because of my introversion, and lucky for me, hindi ako nawala ng trabaho during the pandemic because we were working remotely to start with. Sabi ko jokingly sa peers ko, na-memorize ko na yata lahat ng location ng Paco dito sa kwarto. But as a whole, how did it affect our workplace dynamics? So these are some of the realities in the workplace that a lot of people experience. This is true for the Philippine market, for the Philippine businesses, and at the same time, true globally. This was the result of the Lenovo Global Survey that was done around May of this year, just as the country was easing into the GCQ. So first, the government had to adopt or allowed flexible working arrangements. First was to ensure really physical distance and for health purposes. However, flexible working arrangements were also adopted. And actually, sabi ng government, it's not a matter of you adopting to it or not. It was more of a mandate. And the reason behind that as well is they still want to revitalize the businesses. Ayaw nilang mawala ng trabaho yung mga tao. So the reason behind that is, yes, there's physical distancing, which is first. But if we allow for more flexible working arrangements, then in a way, we can ensure that the business still continues and we will minimize the number of people going out of work as a result of the pandemic. What are some of the flexible working arrangements that probably you have seen or experienced, because probably for some of you that are working have experienced that, your parents, your peers, your siblings. Examples will be, first, they shortened the number of hours. Some companies opted to have a 6-hour shift instead of having 8. Some companies also changed or shifted what we call work days. Some of us were, or some of you probably may have heard of people working for a week, then having an entire work week's worth of rest, and then they would go into the office back again after a week. Some would do that every other or every 2 weeks. Some would do that every other day. But ultimately, it limits the people in the office because capacities have also been reduced, essentially from 0% to 10% gradually. But then it also makes sure that, yes, I may not be going to work, but I still have work, which is critical if we are in this situation where we can't go out, but we still have to eat. Some businesses also shifted their business model. Some companies shifted from a physical store to an online selling platform. Some of them created their own platform. Some of them did third-party selling services or TPSS, like Shopee and Lazada. What did that mean for us? It means that we shifted because business has to continue. Business has to survive as a business owner. If that's my lifeblood, I have to make sure that I make these quick decisions, and one of which was to shift from physical to online. I do some essential oils stuff. So ako yung, if you've heard of it, they call us the oil bulario and the oil bularia. So I have a supplier of my carrier oils that I'm using in Green Hills. It's actually a big market. But when the pandemic starts, Green Hills closed. She lost that store. No one was going there because, number one, she's not an essential service, so they cannot open yet during the ECQ. And they realized that people were still coming up to her to get her products. And she realized that online as a platform now has become an option for a business. Now, because she is continuing the business, she also had to continue operations, meaning she did not let go most of her people. which is critical to the business. The business continued, the business survives. And for some of these companies, in fact, their shift from physical to online became permanent. And then the more common ones that we are hearing is that some companies shifted to remote working setup to ensure business continuity. There are just some companies that cannot stop operating. One such company is our company. In my case, the company is a week ahead. So ECQ or GCQ, the first GCQ was declared on March 15th. We were already working from home as early as March 9th. And we found out later that whether or not the government declared community quarantine, they have already made the decision as early as the first week of March to move to a remote setup. Which brings me to my next point on business. Some businesses are able to execute working from home because they are just more equipped than others. In our case, as a company, we don't have desktops in the office. All of us are issued laptops, which means we can be at any time because essentially the office is in my laptop. But it's not the same case for all companies. Hence, some companies opted for the flexible working relationships arrangements because they still had to have people on site. Manufacturing industries. Hindi mo naman pwedeng dalhin yung raw materials sa bahay mo at doon mo gagawin. Diba? So they still have to continue operations but they just scaled down. Some people opted to change their operating model. Some of them did online. Some of them did delivery instead of pickup. Some did remote working just as our case. Sadly though, some companies just stopped operating and died a natural death. And most of the time, these are companies that are not quick in responding to these changes. Now, what did we learn in all of these? First and foremost, non-traditional working arrangements actually work. There were a lot of questions, okay bang remote working? Baka naman alas gis na ng umaga yung empleyado ko nasa higaan pa. What if they're answering meetings while in bed? Right? So all of these questions and all of these second thoughts and doubts about non-traditional working conditions were actually debunked. In reality, the alternative or flexible working conditions, working from home, online platform, these are not something new. Okay? Hindi ito bago. Sabihin nyo sa akin, hindi nyo pa na-experience mag-Lazada. Hindi nyo pa experience mag-Shopee. Diba? Facebook Market. These are platforms that were readily available. The shift was easy. Remote working is not something new. In fact, in my company, remote working operations was already a thing even when we started 7 years ago. In Twitter, in fact, when they opened, they were already doing remote. And even in legacy companies like Dell, 3M, some of their employees are working remotely. And what did it tell us? It's working. Okay. It brings profit. And it's just a matter of shifting, pushing levers, tweaking your systems a bit. And in fact, some companies realized that these non-traditional working arrangements were actually a better setup for them. I'll give you one. Twitter has decided in April that they will be making their operations fully remote. What happened was they decided that they won't have a physical office. They close down their offices and just make hubs. So what does that mean when we say hub? They are not required to go into the office, but if I want to go to the office, meron po yata tayong audio. If we can just mute, make sure that everyone is on mute, please. Okay, thank you. If Twitter was able to do that, okay, it means that it can be for other businesses. imagine their employees will be working full-time at home. And then if I want to go to the office because I just want to have that office vibe, I can just go in there anytime I want. And this is something that some companies have started to adopt. After the pandemic, they will be creating hubs and not actual office spaces. Now, this non-traditional working arrangement will still continue to evolve. We won't know if working from home will still be the same working from home 10 years from now. But the pandemic really has shifted the landscape. It has shifted the way that we are working. And for some people, they might say na, ah, okay, babalik din naman tayo in our traditional way. Yes, I still believe in that, that when everything has been stemmed, when this pandemic is over, that sense of normalcy that we experienced pre-pandemic will be back. However, it won't be the same. Some businesses, in the business aspect, some businesses will opt to remain remote because to them it's going to be more profitable. It would make sense. It's more practical. There will be institutions that will offer more and more online courses. So back in the days, open universities, self-paced learning, online education is something that only a select few took. But with what we're experiencing right now, there might be some courses that can be taken online. So the spectrum of possibilities just increase. Now, we will talk about at this point, because of the pandemic, what is now the office of tomorrow? How did this pandemic help shape the office of tomorrow? So before I jump into that, just, you know, my caveat here is, and it's a usual question that I get asked. So Pat, ba't pa namin pag-aaralan to? A lot of these things naman pala may not be applicable. Actually, that's where you are wrong. If you're thinking that HR principles will change just because there was a pandemic, I'm telling you now, it won't, because these are foundational things. What I want you to realize is that the business landscape, the workplace dynamics might have changed, but a lot of the things that you are learning right now in school as HR DM students eventually will play a role as you become HR professionals in the future. What is just happening is that there's an evolution. Diba? Think of it this way. Nung kabataan ko, in-na-in ka, pag meron kang Walkman. Kung hindi nyo alam yung Walkman, Google nyo na lang. But right now, there was a time where MP3 players were a fad, which is an upgrade to a Walkman. But right now, we don't see people using MP3 players anymore. Why? Because it's all integrated in your phones. And since we are in the context of music, before, we would buy individual tapes. And then it became CDs, audio CDs of albums of the artists that we want. But right now, you have the likes of Spotify, Deezer, YouTube Music, Apple Music, where you can buy music on the go. But if you take a look at it, you know, the HR practices and even the marketing and sales practices are still the same. It's just being applied. So the office of tomorrow really is just a step up to what we are currently experiencing. The office of tomorrow is a more advanced version. Sabi nga kanina ng first speaker natin, no? We just have to become a better version. And reskilling and upskilling ourselves doesn't mean that we forget what we have learned thus far. So in the office of tomorrow, we would see technology even becoming more important and leveraged in the employee life cycle. So initially, do not be surprised when you start, some of you may be graduating in March, when you do your interviews, all the interview process or the hiring process is done via Zoom, for example, that you won't get to see a recruiter. And even to a certain extent, so the entire process becomes automated. I remember when I applied in my present company, I was interviewed in the office just for my final interview. However, in the signing of the contract, which is usually done on site, now the Philippines has allowed dry signatures or digital signatures, meaning I don't have to physically sign. That's what they call a wet signature. There are certain digital platforms that allow us to sign. Coaching sessions, meetings, seminars like these can be leveraged or can be done by leveraging technology. So what we are doing right now as a webinar is not something new. I'm foreseeing this to even become better in the future as more and more platforms become available. Collaborating and engaging with one another, we might use technology just as what's happening right now, because some of us might be working at home full time. Also, and this was discussed earlier, the office of tomorrow is also an office where employee well-being takes the front seat. One facet of HR is compensation and benefits. And benefits-wise, in a traditional setup, when you talk of benefits, usually the discussion revolves around leave credits. It revolves around maternity benefits, to a certain extent, HMOs or your health cards. But right now, because of the pandemic, we realized even more the importance of ensuring total well-being, most especially mental health. Because we have just been too into the physical health, and mental health really just surfaced as a need a few years ago. Although it was there for the longest time, not a lot of companies actually focus on mental health as a serious threat. And I am a bit passionate about mental health because, in reality, mental health as a condition is the same as any other conditions out there. So mental health, when you talk to someone that has mental health issues, it's not about positive ka lang, magdasal ka lang, huwag ka masyadong mag-isip. No. A person that has a serious mental health, and this is what I also want to take away from this, is a person that has a mental health has problems also with chemicals in the brain. Kaya ang isang tao nagkakaroon ng mental health issue because hormones are raging and it's not natural. Brain chemicals are not working properly. Your neurons are firing at will or not firing at all. That's why you have people that are depressed with no apparent reason. So these are serious medical conditions. That's why there are prescription drugs for mental health. And the care and the concern that we put in for someone that says, that we say has diabetes, has cancer, will now have the same care, the same love and affection, you know, TLC, that we should give to someone that has a mental health issue. I remember one of my teammates in my prior work had some mental health issues, and people were tamad lang yan, tinatamad lang yan, the person is slacking off, wala ng gana. But no, she was having some serious depression issues that she's actually going to the doctor. So in the office of tomorrow, we become an office that's more cognizant, that we realize and we accept people's well-being, most especially when mental health is a reality, and it takes the front seat when we talk about compensation and benefits. The office of tomorrow will also see more and more teams working remotely or at least distributed. So I know this begs the question, but ano yung difference ng remote from distributed? So when you talk of distributed team, okay, in a remote team, you would have like a large group of people in the office and you have several people working remotely, either at home or in a different location. But you have a central group that's still in the office. The difference of distributed from remote is that in a distributed setup, walang headquarters, walang office. So we all are in our own places. It can be your own personal office. It can be a whole working space. And then your teammates are scattered around. And just usually the meeting is virtual. And for some companies, they just go to the office once a month. And we will see more and more of the trends. Why? Because the pandemic has allowed us to see the beauty of remote working in that, sabi natin kanina, this non-traditional work setup works. Now, bakit Patrick, bakit dadami ang remote, bakit dadami ang distributed, ibabalik na tayo sa normal? Yes, but what happens is that in the office now, we would have, because again, we're leveraging technology, we would have people applying from Cebu for an office that is in Manila. Technology allows us to interview that person, go through the entire hiring process. Technology also will allow us to allow that person to work in Cebu if working remotely is an option. And if it would make sense for that person to do it, you're no longer will be limited. Okay, so as HR professionals, you will probably end up as recruiters. You will no longer be limited to a certain location when it comes to your job market. And I have seen that personally. I hired someone in the team, and that person is actually not from Manila, not from the Philippines, but she's a Filipina currently working in Malaysia. And because of the pandemic, hindi siya nakauwi. But we still gave her that working opportunity. In fact, I was able to arrange for her tech devices to be shipped to her in Malaysia. So how great is that? I can work for really big companies in Manila while staying in the province. And what does that do? Diba? Number one, at paborito natin to, sana, dahil dito may iibsan ng traffic because people will not congest Metro Manila anymore. Because while the opportunities are here in Manila, employment and your talent pool is essentially the world. And you will see more and more distributed teams being adopted and working in the office. And these types of teams will produce results, will be productive. The office of tomorrow will also see a lot of cross-border collaboration, primarily because we have already increased our span of market when it comes to talent. And cross-border collaboration is the norm. So I'm going to share with you my own personal experience. I handle a team of, or I am part of a team of people from Sydney and Manila. Okay. However, as our office expands, we also get to interface with people that are in a different area. I get to talk to a contractor in Russia and be in the same meeting from a vendor in Jordan. I'm talking to the same stakeholder, which is in the Czech Republic. And in that same meeting, I also have someone from China and Japan. So this cross-border collaboration becomes a norm. And in our office, and I think in some of the offices right now, because of technology, we have and we are connecting as friends. They are actually my Facebook friends. We would share like nights in Zoom just chatting. We would eat dinner together over Zoom. So things like this, it's part of collaborating. We will be able to deploy a project just by meeting 30 minutes a week. And that's something that the office of tomorrow also brings. You know, as a company, and you will be part of HR later on, you will see that companies will now be more comfortable in this kind of setup. That they will invest heavily in technology. They will invest heavily in capabilities to allow cross-border collaboration. And also as a result, diversity and inclusion levels the playing field. In a study done by Forbes, one of the things that was actually realized during the pandemic was that, mothers who were in the past, hindi naman prevented, but made it challenging for them to do certain things in the office because they have kids that they also attend to. Therefore, it affected their productivity. And in the end, they cannot rival their male counterparts. Now did not have that problem because while working, I'm also at home. Racial divide will be blurred and hopefully eliminated because I can hire someone that's really, really good, not necessarily in my place, not necessarily in my locale, but somewhere else. So the more that your talent pool expands, the more you become diverse as a team. Therefore, if you're not diverse, if you're not inclusive, then there's a possibility that your team will not be successful. So embracing diversity and inclusion becomes a business critical. Okay? Bakit siya business critical? Because first, you level the playing field, equal opportunity for all. And being diverse also allows you to bring in different perspectives that would help you further your goal and accomplish them. Learning pathways over learning curriculum will be the trend as well. And this is here to stay, and we've seen that happening. Back in the days when you were promoted as a supervisor, as a manager, HR would tell you, kailangan mong tapusin to or else hindi ka mako-confirm sa post mo. But right now, because of the pandemic, we have proven that self-paced and asynchronous learning actually works in the same way as non-traditional working arrangements work. And if you give that kind of freedom for people to choose their learning, they actually are more productive and are able to absorb. So yes, meron pa ding face-to-face learning. And mind you guys, pag nagtatrabaho na kayo, it doesn't mean that learning doesn't stop. My work as an L&D facilitator in my prior job was training. So literally, classroom setup, we are in the classroom and I teach them. So para pa rin kayo na sa college. And the difference is, yung buong shift nyo sa 9 hours, dun lang tayo nagkaupo for 1.5 months. So ako yung teacher nyo, para ako yung prof nyo, and you are my students. So learning doesn't stop in the corporate world. Now what happens is that because of technology, we can now make it more self-paced. We can leverage on e-learning that was mentioned already earlier. And the beauty of these learning pathways is that you take it at your own time. So it also boosts productivity. Hindi mo kailangan umabsent or mag-leave para mag-attend ng training. If you have further or professional education that you want to take, profession, kailangan nila ng continuing education credits, yung CE. So as these learning pathways open up, they don't have to take that leave. Okay? Now, lastly, engagement activities for hybrid teams will be more and more available. Funny because I was watching kanina yung intermission number, which by the way, salute to you, ma'am, ang galing ng sayaw natin. Pero yan na rin yung nangyayari in the corporate world. Give me one. Sa company namin, because partner namin ng TikTok, so may pa-TikTok challenge. Okay? We have a fund drive for Bantay Bata. Tapos, it's an online auction. So, no araw na yon, we call that yung pamain na lang. Okay? We would do remote Zoom karaoke. Nagkaroon kami ng we eat together, so we ordered, delivered, pagdating, Zoom na tayo guys, sabay-sabay tayo kumain. It's as if we are at the same lunch table. So in the office, we have what we call season openers. So every quarter, when a new quarter opens, we welcome that with a party. We were so used to having parties in the office, but it was difficult for us to conceptualize. Now that we are doing this remotely, how are we able to do it? But, you know, Pinoy tayo, we are very inventive. We are, our ingenuity is one of our mark. We were able to conceptualize a virtual season opener. And mind you guys, it's challenging because we have to make sure that we do that every quarter. So in the office of tomorrow, you will see engagement activities for hybrid teams becoming more and more available. Some companies already started creating a playbook for this or a menu for this that if you are a remote team, these are the things that you can do to keep employee engagement despite of being a hybrid team. Now, lastly, overall employee experience will now be engineered more than looking at the life cycle. Ano yung pinagkaiba? Employee life cycle is, okay, i-interview kita, i-hire kita, magti-training ka, magsisimula ka magtrabaho, you will receive your coaching session with your boss. Kung kailangan kang mag-training kasi may new skills kang kailangan malaman, you will go through training, you will go through compliance courses, and then eventually, mapapagod ka, magre-resign ka, or tatanda ka, magre-retire ka. That's an employee life cycle. Okay, so from interview to separation. Now, ang focus now becomes employee experience. How do you create peak moments? Because now they see that what was missing, one of the missing pieces during the pandemic is, so how do we make sure that our employees experience the best while working at home, while not being in the office? And sabi natin kanina, there will be an increase of remote and distributed teams. So another question is, if you are in a remote setup, the office people, the group of people in the office will see each other. So how do I make sure that my people in the remote setup will still feel that they are connected to the headquarters? Or even if you are a distributed team. I remembered earlier, I shared with you that we hired someone just a couple of weeks ago. How do I make sure that as her buddy, she still feels connected despite the fact that we have not seen her physically? Okay, so people in our team have been together even before pandemic. So there's a personal setup. There's a personal connection rather. She came and then everything is already virtual. So how do we make sure that she experiences the full suite of our office life without being physically present? How do you celebrate Christmas parties for people that are working remotely? So we engineer this experience to as simple as, how do we welcome a newbie? Magpapadala ba tayo ng gift? Because in the office, we welcome them with a breakfast. But right now, we cannot be together. We put balloons on that person's desk. But I cannot go to your house to put balloons in your room. To start with, that's your house. I don't have to welcome you in your own house. So we engineer experience now. We don't take a look at an employee as someone that goes through a cycle, but we look at the employee as a person that experiences moments while being employed. And we want to make those moments as a defining moment of their employment that eventually lead to a peak moment of their employment. Now, we're talking about all of these shifts and all of these changes. So Patrick, nasan si HR dun? Where are we as HR professionals? Does it mean that we become obsolete or we just all work in the background while we create those e-learning? Yung nakikita nila is yung e-learning na lang. Would they just be seeing us doing the employee packages? We will not even be there in the contract signing because we will just send them the link. Tayo ba as HR professionals, will we just end up as names on their email boxes? There is a lot of discussion about it. And here's a personal take. So in the new normal, it's not just about a shift in technology. Yes, it's given that we have to beef up our technology. In fact, technology is one of the things that emerged as a blocker for some companies that were doing remote. Our connection is not just fast enough. For some of us, well, you already started school, di ba? So, minsan, hindi mo na naabutan yung sinasabi ng teacher nyo. Or, nagpa-group activity si ma'am, 5 minutes. Tapos, 15 minutes na, ba't hindi pa rin siya nagsasalita? Naka-freeze na pala yung screen ni ma'am kasi your internet connection is not as stable. it's not also just a shift in practices. In fact, a lot of these practices pre-pandemic are still effective and in effect. It's just a matter of tweaking them and even operating models. Okay, the new normal is about a shift in culture. Because we have to change our perspective in terms of us being more welcoming to non-traditional work setup, us welcoming the fact that our teammates may not necessarily be someone you can just tap and ask a question, be comfortable over-communicating. One of the critical things in remote working is you over-communicate. So if you're the type of person that really doesn't speak up a lot, you have to have a shift in perspective. I have to ask. Pinoy pa naman tayo nahihiyain, di ba? So we have to change that office culture. And the biggest shift really is culture, more than anything else. Because technology can adapt. Pabilisin ko lang yung internet na yan, okay ka na. However, if the culture doesn't change and the culture does not allow you to embrace these changes, chances are you personally would struggle or the business itself would fail. And in everything that I'm discussing, human resource professionals such as ourselves ensure the workplace remains humanized. And the question I asked earlier, that was asked earlier about interview and what's the purpose of people now, and I'd like to extend the question. So, pat nasan ang tao? Nasan tayo sa equation na yon? Well, good to know that we will not be replaced. Why? Because we can automate interviews. Yes, that's correct. We can make them artificially intelligent through robotics and business insights. However, people will always want to talk to people and interface and commune with other people. Alam nyo kung ano yung greatest worth nyo as HR professionals? Do you know what your greatest competitive advantage is? It's not the skill. I can learn that. It's not the knowledge. I can read about it. Okay? It's not your speed. I can automate. In fact, if I make AI so good, I can replace encoders with machines. Your greatest competitive advantage as an HR professional and any employee for that matter, it's because we are humans. We are the only species that's capable of emotions, capable of relating. Okay? So yun yung pangangalagaan. That's why we call them human resources. Dahil tao sila. The human will still be the greatest resource and the greatest capital. And right at the center of that are us human resource professionals. The pandemic might have caused us to be shaken. It has challenged a lot of principles that we're taught in school. It has changed how we do business. And to a certain extent, it has tried to debunk a lot of our practices. But HR as a profession will still remain because we will be there to humanize. We are there to support people in the office. Guys, in my company, there's no such thing as an HR department. The HR department, we are technically called team happiness. Because we bring happiness to the people in the office by making sure that they have the best workplace in the world to create the best works of their lives. And I think that sums up what HR professional and HR as a profession and as work. We are not just there to create contracts. We are not just there to write memos, write termination letters, write coaching logs. No, we are HR because we are the very first people to take care of our greatest capital, and that is the human capital. At kasama tayo doon. That is something that cannot be taken by machines, which means we are also, as HR professionals, become champions of humanizing the workplace. And that part of our job, I think for me, is one of the most noble facet in my job description, is to make sure that everyone in the company is happy, they have the best experience, we keep the company and the workplace as human as possible. So what we have learned in the pandemic is that it's not just working smart. It's not just about having a great, great, great business plan. It's not having, you know, equipping yourselves with the right skills and knowledge. In the new normal, being adaptive, or your adaptability, your capability to adapt to changes, coupled with your agility, meaning your ability to change directions, will be the game changer. We've seen that in March of this year. On March 16th, the world slowed down. On March 16th, the landscape of the world changed. But it doesn't mean that it will change and will remain, it doesn't mean that it will remain like that for life. Sabi kanina, let's embrace change. Yes, I agree to that. The pandemic itself is bad, but it has taught us a lot. And I think it's fitting for us to talk about the new normal at this time of the year, because 2021 promises a lot of positive prospects in the business world. A lot of trends have emerged. A lot of roles have been created in the HR space, which means for you, there will be a lot to offer. That as HR professionals, hindi lang kayo nasa opisina, nasa harap ng papel. We take a more active role as HR professionals. We are at the forefront of these changes. Sabi nga ng the first speaker natin kanina, we become more engaged in our stakeholders. For me, I see that as we show more and more the humanity of HR. And that wraps up my segment for today. So I'm handing this back to our hosts. Hopefully, you got a thing or two from me today. And let's connect. You can find me on Facebook at Patrick Belliora, or in Twitter using the same handle. I'd love to connect to people. I love to connect to youth. And sabi nga ng first speaker natin, I have also the same feeling. I'm part of teams organizing. Alam ko yung pagod. I've been there. And right now, same with her, paying it forward. And I'm just so glad and honored to be talking to students.
Thank you so much, Mr. Patrick Belliora, for such a phenomenal talk for us.
Grado pong marami ding natutunan ng ating viewers. Siyempre po, pati po kami. Nag-chat down po kami dito ng mga sinabi niyo.
Yes po, thank you po. Thank you so much. So, we have questions. Our classmates and our viewers have questions for you, Mr. Belliora. And first question is?
The first question, sir, is from Mr. Patrick Gutierrez. The question is, how do we get the entire company, including our leadership team, on board with diversity and inclusion initiatives?
Good question. Tukayo ko pala yung nagtanong. The ideal really is you don't get them on board. It's business leaders that should have diversity and inclusion as part of their initiative. That's one of the things na ako, very critical. I am actually a diversity and inclusion champion in my company. And critical to any successful D&I culture is that you don't get the support. Hindi support ang kukunin mo. Sila mismo makikita nila yung value at sila yung nagpo-push nun. Right? So if the question is how do you make them see the importance of diversity and inclusion in the workplace, number one, you'd be glad to know that D&I is an emerging practice, which means ang dami ng mga kumpanya na pwede mong gawin as reference. Large companies that have leveraged on diversity and inclusion, I'll give you one. If you are familiar with the US banking giant JP Morgan and Chase, JPMC actually has a long-standing HR policy to maintain a certain, as much as possible, a 50-50 ratio of male to female in any level of the organization. For them, it's critical that even at the level of the board, 50-50 ang representation ng male and female. Okay? So you can use that as reference. Another is you can also cite the importance of not leveraging, but performance as a measure, performance-based. So differently abled people, kasi they're called differently abled, and guys, hindi siya PWD ha, a person with disability is no longer being used as a term. So we call them differently abled people. Kasi iba lang ang mga kakayahan nila. We call them differently abled because they can also contribute. Okay? So for me, ako, ang ginagamit ko talagang trick with stakeholders is proof of concept. So if yung question natin is, how do you get the buy-in of your executives and your leaders? Draw in inspiration from outside. Look for companies that have D&I. And do not be surprised. Diversity and inclusion is now part of the values of most companies. Remember earlier, sabi ko, may mga nagawang bagong posisyon. Diversity and inclusion right now is emerging to be one separate department of HR. Hindi na siya part ng HR. So mayroon ng diversity and inclusion as a department. So ka-level na siya ng sales, ka-level na siya ng HR. So you'd be glad to know that marami ng companies ang gumagawa niyan. And I'm happy personally because that's shifting.
Thank you so much, sir. So here's the last question. What is the most important thing will do to help us or to be successful in working remotely?
Number one, for me, I guess, for you to be successful in working remotely is personal leadership. Number one yun for me. Be able to lead yourself, ang sabi nila doon, personal leadership. Know what is required of you and work on it. Pero to be successful in remote working, you should also learn as part of personal leadership when not to work. Kaya nasistress ang maraming tao sa remote working kasi when you wake up, office mo na yon. So siguro story lang, no? Kami sa Philippines, parati kami naiinggit sa mga counterparts namin sa Sydney tsaka sa US kasi malalaki yung bahay nila, magaganda. They have dedicated offices. So pag nagme-meeting kami, nakikita namin parang ay, ang ganda naman ng bahay nila, may sarili silang office. Samantalang kami, 'di ba? Ako minsan sa higaan lang. Yung iba sa dining table, yung iba sa sala. So, you wake up that already is your office. If you don't have a solid personal leadership, hindi mo kayang i-manage yung sarili mo na, "Hey, it's 7 o'clock, my shift starts at 7." And I have to start working at 7, then doon pa lang mag-feel ka na. Kung hindi mo kayang sabihin sa sarili mo na alas 4 na ng hapon, tapos na ng trabaho, at nag-i-extend ka araw-araw, na nangyari sa akin. So ito, very personal to sa akin, no? I wake up at 6:30, tapos dito lang ako sa kwarto, nagtatrabaho, walang kain, except for pansit canton. Tapos magugulat ako pagtingin ko sa bintana, it's dark. Alas 8 na pala ng gabi. So it would take its toll on you. Okay? It would take its toll on you. That's where mental health issues start. That's where fatigue starts. And gusto kong i-extend to sa inyo, sa students. Okay? Personal leadership doesn't start in the workplace. It starts with you sa school. Kung alam nyo, may klase kayo kay Ma'am Gimari ng alas 7 ng umaga, kailangan pagdating ng 7, nasa Zoom ka na or naka G Suite yata kayo, ready. Diba? may mga working students tayo na nag-a-attend for sure. And alam natin ang dynamics ng working student. Di ba pag nagtrabaho ka, pag sinabi ang shift mo ay alas 7, dapat nandun ka na sa work. Di ba? That's why a lot of working students are successful. Alam nyo bakit? Because they have personal leadership. And I salute you for being a working student. Kasi madadala nyo yan. Madadala nyo yan. Because I was also a working student. Yes, nagtrabaho ako sa Jollibee. Nagtrabaho din ako sa McDonald's. At alam natin ang buhay fast food. And that facet is not something that you can be trained on. Number one, that part of you is not something that you will learn in school. That's something that you would have to develop yourself. Diba? Bakit kailangan naming sabihin, and hindi lang to sa mga teachers nyo, no? Baka sinasabi nyo sa teachers nyo lang, kami ang policy sa office pag nag-video call, video on. Diba? May ganun kayong policy, alam ko yon. Video on dapat. Because kailangan, it's a way for you to be attentive. Diba? Kasi pag naka-video on. Some schools and even some companies would still require people to be at business attire. Kami kasi sa company namin, laid back eh. Naka-shorts nga lang ako pumapasok. Okay? So, okay kasi sa amin yun. But there are some companies that would require business. Kung ano yung damit mo sa office is still the same that they require you to be when you're doing your Zoom calls. Because it creates that. It's still personal leadership. But more importantly, personal leadership also means that you take it upon yourself to improve, to upskill, to be ready, and to be accepting of things that are happening. Sabi ko kanina, adaptability and agility, nagsastart yun sa personal leadership. Kung ikaw mismo ayaw mo, wala akong magagawa. Di ba? Kung ikaw mismo hindi mo gusto, wala tayong magagawa. Okay? A lot of the things that will make you successful in the office, regardless of what you will be doing in the future, and a lot of the things that will make you successful in life starts with you. Your decisions and your ability to bounce back are just parts of it. Pero lahat ng to babalik at babalik sa kung sino at ano ka. And I think that for me is an ingredient, not just to be successful in remote working, but being successful as a whole.
Thank you so much, Mr. Villiora. And I'm sure that our audience got a full knowledge and other ideas from your talk. Thank you so much.
Sa mga viewers natin dyan, huwag lang tayo basta makikinig. Dapat isa puso natin para ma-apply natin in the future.
Yes, kasi napaka-importante ng mga narinig natin ngayon from our two speakers dahil sobrang knowledgeable yung mga sinabi nila.
And to acknowledge your effort, sir, we will now proceed to the handling of certificate and also the reading of the plaque of appreciation. May we call on again Ms. Sheena Mercado to formally read the plaque of appreciation.
Eloyo Amang Rodriguez, Institute of Science and Technology, College of Business Administration, Human Resource Development Management. Certificate of Appreciation is presented to Patrick Joseph C. Villiora in grateful recognition for sharing his expertise and professional competence as webinar speaker on the topic, Envision the Future Human Resource, Embracing the Changes, Shifting Towards New Normal. Given this 12th of December 2020, Iris Manila. Signed, Kimberly Christian Q. Rueda, President, HRDM 41, Professor Marilyn S. D. Marie, Advisor, HRDM 41, Dr. Charlene U. Escario, Air Chairperson, HRDM, and Dr. Willie O. Gapasin, Dean, College of Business Administration.
Yay!
Thank you so much, Ms. Sheena. And thank you again, Mr. Villiora. And we are hoping to see you again.
I think sana makita namin ko personally to interact with you for another webinar or seminar. And also, sir, the certificate will be delivered to you personally by Ms. Sandayan and Ms. Malyari together with our token of appreciation. So once again, sir, thank you so much sa time.
Yes, thank you so much, sir. And now, before we proceed to the next part, I know Ayun. That all of you guys are waiting for some icebreaker.
So kung kanina, sinayawan tayo ni Miss Angel Rises. Ngayon, kakantahan naman tayo. So sino nga ba to?
Then, pakilala na natin.
Let's give it up for Mr. Japet Lapidario.
Everybody needs inspiration. Everybody needs a song, a beautiful melody. When the nights are long, 'cause there is no guarantee that this life is easy. My world is falling apart when there's no light to break up the darkness. When I look at you, when the waves are flooding the shore and I can't find my when I look at you, I see forgiveness. I see the truth. You love me for who I am. Like the stars hold the moon, right there where they belong. And I know I'm not alone, yeah, when my world is falling apart, when there's no light to break up the darkness, when I look at you, when the waves are flooding the shore, I can't find my way home anymore. That's when I look at you. You appear just like a dream to me, just like kaleidoscope colors that cover me. All I need, every breath that I breathe, don't you know you're beautiful?
Voice, Mr. Lapidario.
So, walang mag-change career.
Yes, ang galing. So, huwag na nating patagaling to.
Ito na po.
At this moment, there's someone who gave us her inspirational message. So, let's all welcome Mr. Dr. Charlene Scarlo.
And good morning to everyone. I would like to congratulate Mom Gimari and the team for making this successful for all the participants, and it was indeed a successful one. For our astonishing speaker, Ms. Radhika Nay and Mr. Pat Deloria, for making their expertise to our future practitioners. What could have been your takeaways? These are, we are now in a new normal, all challenges, the way you have. All the challenges has just come naturally to us. And as Sir Pat Bell shared to the Office of Tomorrow's challenges to embrace are to be collaborating. Cross-border collaboration will be part of the new normal challenges, and a great opportunities will be open. And not limited to a new normal, with the upskills and rescaling does not tell you to forget the tradition, but to embrace the creativeness and the opportunities to evolve and get connected. Communicate widely to be more productive. As mentioned by Mr. Nahe, new technology and e-learning pathways still remain focused, as Mr. Nahe mentioned, and to be more humanized as HR. Robotics may replace the technical works of HR work and determine algorithms in recruiting for the most qualified applicants, but it cannot replace the compassion of being an ambassador of happiness in the workplace to bring out the best for the employees. Changes is constantly approaching. Be useful and react to involve, as Mr. Nahe reiterated. Act like an executive or having an executive mindset as if you were manifesting a reality. Shifting to a new normal is a calling to embrace opportunities and get excited to learn new technology to upskill and rescaling. And there's a lot of courses online to park yourself. Managing to increase your personal leadership is a successful way, especially in a remote workplace. Who are you makes up you for being successful in the future. Never stop learning and take this as a normal setting by being proactive and equip yourself with the new skills that will come your way. Again, congratulations to Mom Gimari and the rest of the team. Good morning. Thank you.
Thank you so much, ma'am.
Thank you,
Dad.
Thank you, Ma'am.
Speech, ma'am. Thank you so much po. And now, at this moment, we may call on...
Yun, tatapos na tayo po, yes. Ano, Lalin. So, for the closing remarks, may we call on Mr. Cham E. Cornelio,
the co-event manager of this event, for the closing remarks. Before that, we would like to remind all the viewers, audience, that about the
feedback form.
It is already pinned in the comment section, so just click below and...
Before, after this webinar po, it will automatically open, so just relax there.
Yes. Para po, yun po yung feedback form po na yun, purpose is para po makuha natin ang ating mga e-certificate.
Yes po, para po meron tayong remembrance po sa naganap na webinar for this day.
Yes. And kamusta naman kayo dyan, mga audience? So ngayon, lapit na tayong matapos. And again, shall we call on Ms. Cham Cornelio?
Yes, tawagan po namin muli si Mr. Cham E. Cornelio para po sa ating closing remarks.
Thank you.
First of all, I would like to thank our speakers. It was a pleasure having Ms. May and Mr. Joseph share their thoughts, remarks, and possibilities as we move from this tragic yet undeniable ship that does only what the world has to take. We all know the severe impact has the community and to everything else we thought was normal and unchangeable. Billions of lives affected, yet we continue to strive and go hand to hand, doing nothing and everything to suppress it. So we also thank you for your resiliency. And lastly, on behalf of every of HRTM41, we would like to thank everyone who lent us their valuable time to listen and exchange their personal thoughts with us as well. We definitely look forward to meeting you soon, and always keep in mind, stay safe and God bless. Thank you.
And thank you, Mr. Cham Cornelio, for your closing remarks.
Thank you, Cham.
Paano yan? Halos patapos na tong webinar natin.
Siyempre, di naman tayo papayag nang walang kasunod yan. So, sisiguraduhin po namin na more webinars to come pa.
Yes. At laisan po namin kamustahin kayo kung ayos pa ba yung ating online class.
Yes. Always stay safe po tayo lagi. Yes. Lalo sa panahon ngayon, pandemic. Huwag po tayo lagi labas na labas kung di naman kailangan.
Yes. At sa mga graduating ngayon, gusto po namin i-congratulate ang lahat na malapit na tayo. Yes! So,
hindi ako makapaniwala.
Yes. Parang
kailan lang, di ba?
Parang kaka-enroll ko lang ng first year.
Parang first year lang tayong nakaraan eh.
So
ngayon to, webinar, fourth year, next graduation.
Sa dami ng pinagdaanan natin, finally we're here, guys!
Ayun nga po pala, binabati po namin ang isa po sa aming mga naging professor, Dr. Ana Victoria Mylas. Happy birthday, ma'am!
Happy
birthday po, ma'am!
Yes, and we would like to thank all of you for being here, for supporting us, participated in this event. So we would like to thank all of you. This event won't be successful without you guys. Thank you so much.
Yes, thank you so much, lalo na po sa aming advisors. Prof. Marivic Gimari, ma'am, thank you so much sa guide, sa tulong. Kung wala po kayo, syempre po, hindi naman po magiging matagumpay itong event natin. Also, sa lahat po ng HRDM41, sa effort po,
yes,
sa lahat ng nagpuyat para po maging possible ang ating webinar.
Yes.
And also,
at alam ko na halos lahat nag-effort para sa webinar na to. Gusto ko lang congratulate tayong lahat dahil sa ginawa natin, sa pagtutulungan nating lahat. Thank you so much, guys.
We also acknowledge our professors na nanonood din po.
Yes.
Co-students from different majors, from
sections. And
yes.
So, thank you for watching us.
And also, we will also acknowledge our Dean, Dr. Willie O. Gapasin. Hi, sir.
Hi, sir. Thank you.
Thank you
so much for supporting us. So,
and also, si Sir Doroteo po. Siyempre, sagay din po ni Sir Doroteo.
Thank you
so much po.
Thank you. We are so grateful for that. And before we end this program and this webinar,
I am Armar Pionela.
I am Floralyn Mulikas.
Thank you so much, and God bless us. So, to end this, we will sing the Iris hymn.
Join us singing the Iris hymn.
Bye, guys.
Let the Iris